I'm sitting my photo blind, and this is the first time this year I'm down here. Like, you can probably see this is the permanent blind, not the tragopan. Outside there is dead, there's nothing. But I've sprinkled out some peanuts and some sun seeds, and I really, really hope that I can attract some birds, because the frost will come next week, and I just want the birds to get used to me being here. Last season was very good because I could sit in here with my telephoto lens sticking out, and they didn't bother that much, and even the buzzard came and the ravens and stuff. So yeah, but look what I have in front of me. I have this guy. It's the game camera, and it has been sitting here whole night. It was actually supposed to send me pictures if something happened, but let's try to get it. This guy is one of these game cameras that sends photos to your phone, or you can just set it so it takes photo and doesn't send them to the phone. And it's an awesome way to actually see what's going on in nature when you're not there. And I found many foxes and badgers and stuff with this guy. This one is set up to actually send photos to my phone, but it doesn't. So either there hasn't been anything here during the night, or it's just not working. But I brought my computer, and I thought when we're having a little break, we can have a look at these pictures. First, I want to set up my 600mm. Like, I brought my 600, I brought my Tamron, and I'm setting up the 600 now, I think, on the tripod, pointing out, also just so the birds can get used to there is something, and then they can decide if they want to come here or not. So yeah, and not to forget, look what I also have. The coffee, freshly brewed back home. So when everything is set up, when the camera is pointing out, it's time to have a cup of coffee. Maybe time to have a look if there is anything, if this one has captured anything during the night. So it's awesome to be back in the photo blind. I love to be here. It's really, really, really nice. It's so comfortable and cozy. And okay. Magpies now, and I heard the crows. I can see the magpies are sitting down in the pine trees in the background. So I think now, with the telephoto lenses up, it's just about waiting. I just like to see the birds, and actually it's not very often that I photograph them. Sometimes I just go here and have a look at the small birds taking the seeds and stuff. And I love to attract birds to my garden during the winter. And I just make sure that if I start giving them seeds, I continue during the winter. So it's not that I go and give them a lot of seeds, and then when I'm done with my photography, I just forget them, because then the poor little guys will just have this habit to come for food and water in my garden. So, I think it's time to a cup of coffee. Oh wait, let's turn off the camera first. Maybe it is working, and then it's filming in here. Maybe it's run out of batteries actually. Let's see. Maybe we can see if there are any pictures on it. If I turn it on, see? It says low battery. Low battery. Oh, this one doesn't look good. Okay, let's see. We have this one now, and I have new batteries. Maybe on this one there is something, but we will find out. And I totally forgot to tell that I'm actually not here alone. I brought a friend today. Maybe it'll be polite of me to introduce. So, look here. He's sleeping. Bjorn. Bjorn. Hi. Hi. Are you sleeping? Sorry. The little guy is here, sleeping on the little skin. He doesn't care about these birds, but I thought it's more interesting for him to be here than actually being home alone. So yeah, let's get some coffee. It's coffee time. Oh, it's so good. It's like nothing better than sitting here in the photo blind, listening to the magpies, and I can see they're sitting there considering should they come down and have a peanut or should they not. And I'm sitting here with the camera, have a cup of coffee. Oh, it's awesome. Oh, by the way, I think there's a few things I have to catch up on, and I think this was a very good opportunity to like update you on what's happening. First of all, the Tamron, this guy. Yeah, this guy. You know, I had the issues in Scotland where the focus just stopped working, and I see some moisture inside, so I send it over and I got it back, and they like kind of, I was promised that they would like tell me, get an answer on how wet the seal is and what was actually wrong and stuff. But I didn't get anything. I just got the repair note saying that they have replaced the focus motor, they have replaced the lens element, they have like adjusted the contacts between the lens and the camera. That's it. And then I went out with the lens in the other day, and it focused perfectly and it's super sharp. It's brilliant. It is just as good as it always is, but it still has this issue. And I would love to hear if any of you have had the same issue, where I press the focus, there's like the focus go to affinity or something, and then it just, you can hear the focus motor is continuing to run, like, but nothing happens. It's like, yeah, I can't explain it. And then when I try to focus on something else, even though it's high contrast, even though it's perfect lit, I focus and adjust it without moving the actual element inside, so it doesn't focus. It just say the sound of the focus motor. Yeah, so it's weird. I still love the lens. I still bring it because often it helps to like turn off the camera, take the lens just a little bit off, put it on again, turn on the camera, and then I'm good to go. If you're out there and you have this like this opportunity of like a fox coming through the grass and it's beautiful lit and everything is just awesome, you have been waiting for that moment, and then suddenly the lens start to be like, it's really, really, I love the Tamron, but it's just now where I've had these issues. I just don't trust it anymore. But I hope it's just mine. I hope no one else is having these issues. I hope it's just mine, and I wish they would just replace it. But we'll see. Anyway, now everything is perfect. I wish. I could see just a glimpse of a bird out there. It would be awesome. Should we see if there is anything on the memory card? Just while we're waiting, I have my laptop. We can go and check out if there is anything. So yeah, let's do that. Okay, at least there should be a picture of me when I was setting it up.
Oi. Oi, 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 oi. Do you see them? What are the birds? Magpies, crows, buzzard. There's a buzzard sitting right there. Definitely a buzzard sitting there. Let's see if we can see the photo. See? That's the buzzard. What else do we have? Here. That's the buzzard. And that's the buzzard. There are two buzzards. Okay, wait a second. Buzzard, crows. Buzzard, crows. Look at that photo. Look at the photo. It's a buzzard in the air. Okay. Now I'm scaring away everything here. Let's see. Holy moly. Look at this. Do you see this guy? Wait, let me zoom in. This is awesome. Wait. This is awesome. Okay, look there. Wait. Look right there. Do you see? The fox. Let's see, maybe next video he comes. No, he doesn't. Damn it. Where is he? That was awesome. There are magpies outside now. Just the fact that I moved, you saw how little I moved the thing here. And everyone are gone now. There were like 20 out there. It is so hot, but it's the first time down here. Isn't it amazing? Oh, it's definitely getting cold. Wait. They are back, all of them. Just keep in. It's getting cold. Oh, that was better. Okay, let's see if we can get something. Let's see if we can make some video of these. Thank you.
totally dead outside now. When I tried to move the little vlogging camera behind me so you could see the live view on the video, like I made too much movement, so all the birds were gone. And now I've been sitting here for quite a long time and nothing has happened. I don't know if you can hear Björn is snoring down there. The little guy. So it's time to pack. I think, like, taking into consideration that it is the first time I'm here this year, like this season, and I've been vlogging, I've been talking, I've been moving the camera forth and back, and like, I mean, it's pretty good that I've seen so many magpies out there. I think I'll come here a lot during January, February, maybe March, and I'll definitely bring you with me when we go down here. And one thing is sure, if snow is falling in Denmark, we are going down here to sit and see if we can photograph the buzzards or the magpies in the snow. It's going to be awesome. So I think it's time now for me to pack my stuff together and get that little lazy dog home. No, the last little thing I want to talk about is, you probably noticed my last two videos from where I was out. The first one, which was really fun to make, was a day in the forest doing bushcraft. I don't know if you have seen the video, but I'll put a link up there. It was really, really nice to make that video. Like, I wasn't saying anything on the video. I was just like faffing around, doing some bushcraft, making some pictures. And I know some of you were like saying in the comments, like, oh, why have you stopped talking? I have not stopped talking, as you can hear now. Now you have been listening to me talking for minutes after minutes. But it's just, the one thing is, sometimes when I do these YouTube videos, you know, it takes a lot of time talking to the camera. And when I'm talking to you right now, I'm not watching out there all the time. And when I'm in the forest with my camera, looking for the deer, looking for the fox, I do make the videos sometimes where I'm telling what I'm doing, but it's also very nice for me not to have to say anything. Like, I might talk to Björn or I might talk to myself, but it's hard to explain, but it's just so much easier to reconnect, like be there and be present in the moment. And furthermore, I have missed some chances out there because I'm vlogging, because I'm talking to the camera, and then I scare things away. And I think I'm just starting to, sometimes I'm explaining you things like I do now, but other days I'm just bringing the camera because the alternative is that I'm not bringing it. So I just want to bring you out there with me and just show you what's going on, and just hope it's good enough. So yeah, I don't know if you saw that video, but have a look at it, and you can have 22 minutes or something of me saying nothing. Then you can rest your ears after this talk. So that was a lot of talk. Oh, it's beautiful out there. Let's go home. See you out there.